Fresh water from rain that falls on a dune on an island in sea causes the development of a freshwater hydraulic head, HD, relative to mean sea level. As the infiltrating and percolating freshwater replaces the saline water originally present below the surface, and as freshwater has a slightly lower density than saline water, a freshwater lens will develop that floats on the denser saline water. This figure shows the situation for an unconfined aquifer in an island with a precipitation surplus after equilibrium has been reached. A precipitation surplus means that precipitation exceeds evaporation on a yearly basis. This figure is for a large part comparable to what we will encounter along the Dutch coast. It is interesting to compute depth of the freshwater lens as this provides an important source of drinking water. Freshwater has a density rho f of 1000 kg per cubic meter, whereas saline groundwater has a density rho s of 1025 kg per cubic meter. If we assume hydrostatic conditions, no groundwater flow at the interface of the fresh and saline groundwater, a sharp interface and no mixing of the fresh and saline water, we can compute the depth of the freshwater lens relative to the mean sea level as follows. The hydraulic head equals the sum of the elevation head and pressure head. Now select a reference level where the elevation head equals zero anywhere along the interface of the fresh and saline groundwater. It doesn't matter where you select this. Once you have selected it, stick to it. Let's select the bottom of the freshwater lens as reference level. When the elevation head equals zero, the hydraulic head logically equals the pressure head. This is true for both the fresh and saline groundwater at the sharp interface. For the hydraulic head at the interface in fresh water, we can write this equation. The hydraulic head HF, which is HS plus HD in the fresh water, equals the pressure head in the fresh water, which we can rewrite as follows. Equally, for the hydraulic head at the interface in saline water, we can write this equation. The hydraulic head in the saline water equals the pressure head in the saline water, which we can rewrite as follows. Physically, there can only be one pressure P at any point in the groundwater. Consequently, setting these equations equal and solving for HS delivers this equation. This relation is true at every location along the interface of the fresh and saline groundwater. It is known as the Ghijben-Herzberg relation after the Dutch engineer officer Ghijben and the German engineer Herzberg. If we take rho f equal to 1000 kg per cubic meter and rho s to 1025 kg per meter, the equation reduces to this equation. Thus, the thickness or depth of a freshwater aquifer under hydrostatic equilibrium conditions, HS plus HD equals approximately 41 times HD. HD is called the convexity or differential head. The convexity or differential head is defined as the difference in altitude between the top of the water table and the open water surface, which is the sea level here. The actual situation encountered below coastal dunes may differ from the above. In the coastal dunes of the Netherlands, an important source of drinking water, as mentioned before, HS plus HD is 15 to 25 times HD. The main reason is that the subsurface of these coastal dunes almost always contains separating clay layers that resist the infiltration of fresh water. Also, the interface between fresh and saline water is not sharp. Due to molecular diffusion and the movement of chemicals from regions with high concentration to regions with low concentration, the interface consists of a transition zone of brackish water, water that is intermediate to fresh and saline water. This figure is a geohydrological profile through the western part of the Netherlands, Holland. Here we have the mean sea level, the dunes, the Holocene polders, and some 50 kilometers to the east, a Pleistocene ice-pushed ridge. The subsurface is made up of fresh, brackish, and saline groundwater. Fresh groundwater as a source of drinking water is found both below the coastal dunes and under the ice-pushed ridge. When both fresh and brackish or saline water are present in the subsurface, observed hydraulic heads are no longer an adequate measure of the total energy of the groundwater, unless their values are corrected for differences in the density of the groundwater. Usually, the saltwater hydraulic head HS, shown to the far left here, is translated to an equivalent freshwater hydraulic head HF, as shown here. HF is larger than HS. We can determine the equivalent freshwater head in a similar way as we just did in deducing the Ghijben-Herzberg relation. The hydraulic head in saline water, HS, equals the elevation head, Z, plus the pressure head of P over the saline water density, rho S and G. From this we can establish P over G. Similarly, the equivalent freshwater head, HF, would equal the elevation head Z plus a freshwater pressure head of P over a freshwater density rho F and G. Again, we can establish P over G. Setting these equations for P over G equal to each other delivers the equivalent freshwater head as shown here. And then for rho F is 1000 kg per cubic meter and rho S is 1025 kg per cubic meter. This is the equation. A much encountered problem is salinization of freshwater pumping wells, as shown here for the pumping well to the left, where brackish groundwater is pumped out. We see the buildup of the subsurface. We have freshwater at the top, and brackish and saline water deeper down, as indicated by the chloride concentrations of the water to the left. The subsurface is made up of, from bottom to top, an equitard, an aquifer, an equitard, an aquifer, and an equitard. And the left situation can be mitigated or even prevented by using the freshkeeper concept as shown to the right. Here again we have the pumping well pumping for fresh water. We don't want brackish water or saline water to enter this pumping well. What we can do is we can install another pumping well below, which pumps away the brackish water at the same time. Now the interface between the fresh water and the brackish water is kept at its place here. The brackish water can serve as an additional source for drinking water after desalination with a process called reversed osmosis as shown here at 2, with, if allowed by law, the reversed osmosis concentrate, a byproduct of the reverse osmosis, disposed of by deep well injection at 3. The freshkeeper concept has been piloted in the Netherlands since 2009. In April 2018, an earlier abandoned well field has been reopened to produce 1 million cubic meters of drinking water using this freshkeeper concept.